What's up, guys, and welcome back to Life is Strange Before the Storm. Now, I know that I said that next time would be the last episode, and it was, yes, technically it was, but we do have this bonus episode, and I want to get through all of it before I play the Adventures of Captain Spirit and whatnot. So, that's what we're going to do today. We're going to do the bonus episode.
Ready, I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak?
She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor.
Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Me, that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen.
Yes, you are insane.
You're insane. That explosion was massive. You say that like it's a bad thing.
Pretty sure your mom would think so. Let's hope she didn't hear.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Okay, then. It's so different. Like, I'm so used to
her. Feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now.
I'm so used to Chloe being all like, you know, like, hell the cool
in a few days,
bad it.
My whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye.
I mean, thank you for cutting me off, Max, but, you know, whatever.
But how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
You know,
I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place. I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter. I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Alright, so I guess we need to just get rid of things. She's probably not going to want to get rid of anything, right?
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way.
Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
What? We never play. What?
Chloe, We haven't played this game in years. And it's missing half the pieces.
Nice try, Max. But you can't erase your shame that easily.
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Sure.
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts.
All right. Back to the junk mines.
This
what about
seems
this?
Like a good candidate.
Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
So lame. You never use it.
You haven't touched these since the 5th grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
Yeah.
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
What's in here?
What about this half-eaten jawbreaker?
Ugh.
It's a serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
Ew! Lick it, toss it. You know what?
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
Oh my god, it's gross.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and... tell her later.
Tell her now, tell her later. I guess we could just enjoy the day together.
The possibilities are endless. Got anything in mind?
Actually, you bet your ass I do. I found this when I was digging around before you got here. You're gonna flip! Do you have any idea what this is?
Not
You're
really?
You're the one with the killer memory. Not me.
Very true. One of my finest traits, along with humility. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! Ye have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia! Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver!
We were such dorks.
You're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches.
What? Get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it.
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck, and... bye.
So cringe.
That was...
dorky, hilarious, amazing.
Hilarious. We were so, so ridiculous.
We still are, Max. We still are. Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting.
Aww.
I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
I just realized her shirt is a cat pirate. That's adorable. There's a boat. Oh my god, they're so cute! Oh, her cat.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
All right. Time to find this map. Don't move.
Of course, we have to take
this
a photo.
This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude.
A photograph with Chloe. Yes, with.
Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
Where could that map be?
I feel stupid.
Bingo. I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet.
Which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
Was? Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver ride again, bitches!
Chloe seems so into this. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Exactly.
Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little strange when I asked her about school earlier. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about?
Oh, Chloe.
There it is. The dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on.
Well, she didn't really need that bench then if she's gonna stand on all those books. It's not safe.
Finally. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works. Lee Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
Max bothers me. Like, I understand it's from, like, a kid's perspective and whatnot, you know? But she acts like she's never gonna hear from her ever again. Like, can't you call her? Like, I don't know. That kind of irks me just a tad.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
I don't know.
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend. That's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. Did you find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way.
Dude, you did it!
No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Oh, this is... Bongo was already... Oh.
Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard.
Yeah.
Hey,
and of course, another
Chloe.
Photo.
Yar.
Walk the plank. Land ho. Yes.
Land ho!
Perfect.
Wait just a minute. Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot or peg on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I'll find something to hold it on.
Thanks, Max.
What's this?
I miss you, buddy.
Oh, that's sad.
Oh, here we go. Tape.
Score. One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is. If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Not even if you tried. Losers together.
Yeah, totally. But we're losers together.
If you're a loser, Max, I don't think I want to be cool. It's just, this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way. Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait, how am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something.
Here goes nothing.
I think we buried it over there. Do you see anything, Max?
Or where?
Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
I was just looking right there! Go,
Okay, take a step right. No, no, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
How does that line up with anything?
No, let's open it.
Oh, it's a time capsule thing.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape layer.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you.
Aww.
Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you are so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine, you were really sweet.
Oh, man, I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop. This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
Probably should.
This is Anne Rogers, Marissa's mother. Marissa from Blackwell. I need to talk to you about what your daughter did to Marissa in class today. I'll be keeping Marissa home with me tomorrow. At this point, I'm not comfortable sending her back to school at all. I don't know if your daughter's having trouble adjusting or what, but this needs to be addressed.
Hey, hold on.
Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Shit.
Yeah, I was snooping and I saw it.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
Gotta tell me.
Come on. You've gotta tell me what happened. I'm your best friend.
Man, none of this would have happened if I had you around. I wouldn't care what anyone said. Sorry. I don't mean it's your fault. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner in science. Just a little.
What?
Jeez.
No one got hurt. Not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
That really sucks. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Thanks, Max. Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
Oh, gosh. I really miss Bongo.
Aw.
I saw you giving him a flower. It was so sweet.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
tell her? Don't tell her. I guess we should.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What?
Oh, she knew.
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
Aw. Why did you pretend? Should have told you earlier. Yeah, why did you pretend?
Why did you pretend like you didn't know?
I don't know. I guess I didn't want it to be true. We were both doing it, weren't we? All that pirate stuff, doing the treasure hunt. Wasn't that fun?
Of course, but...
Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
Oh, my heart. I keep in touch and visit. I'm worried I won't be okay.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit and... Maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Oh... Oh no. Rivers cracked and cold. See the sky is no man's land. A dark and plumed estate. Hope your needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place. Oh, God. I don't like that they put this at the end of the last. Why couldn't have this one come first? And then, before the storm, like, why? Why did they have to do it like this? Comfort came against my will. Every story must grow old. Still I be a traveler. A gypsy's rhymes to face. But the road is weary.
this I know. But can't you see, or maybe you were.
Oh God. I don't have any words. Recorded something before he left.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh no, Chloe did. I mean, Max did.
I guess I just wanted to leave you one more message. Because I know this was the absolute worst time for me to go. I thought maybe if you heard my voice, it could be a little bit. There. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if I never... Even if we're moving for good, we are always together. Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you. Goodbye.
Oh my God. My heart. And that was the bonus episode. Great. Well, I'm gonna go try not to continue to cry. That actually hurt my heart just a little bit. Well, that's that. I hope you all have enjoyed Life is Strange Before the Storm, and it sucks. That is the worst thing to end on, and I apologize. Yeah. Hope you all have enjoyed. I'm sorry if I made you all sad with this bonus episode. And, I'm gonna go play something else now to make me feel better. So, I'll see you guys next time.